San Diego has long been a hub for scientific advances, and that is continuing in the treatment and detection of HIV/AIDS. Joining me are two local researchers working to prevent the spread of the disease. Dr. Sheldon Morris is with UCSD Antiviral Research Center, and Dr. Davey Smith is Associate Professor of Medicine at UC San Diego. Dr. Morris, there's been a lot of buzz around this new drug called Tovada. You participated in some local research on this. What does the drug do, and what are some of the challenges?
Well, this is a drug that we've used for a long time for treatment of HIV for people that are infected. It's one of our favorite drugs, backbone therapy. It's a combination of two medications, and there's been several studies that have proven that it's very effective in reducing the chances of somebody that's not been infected, who is at risk, and reducing their chances of getting HIV. Some of the challenges, though, are clearly that how do you use this and how do you roll this out into a prevention in both the developed and developing countries. The cost is quite high, and who is going to prescribe it, who are you going to give it to? There's a lot of questions.
And Dr. Smith, so how do you get around that?
You do studies, just like what Dr. Morris is planning in his group, is to go out and see who needs the medication, who can take the medication, what are the side effects, what are the adverse events, because there are going to be some, and do the risks actually outweigh the benefits? And the only way to do that is in a clinical trial, which is what is planned. The good thing about this is that San Diego has been very generous, especially among high-risk communities in San Diego, coming together to enroll and participate in science. That's the reason that San Diego is one of the forefront leaders in HIV research for decades.
And Dr. Smith, now you've recently received a grant that will allow you to study the disease, how it spreads. What is going to be your area of focus?
So the main part of my project is to figure out what is the transmission network overall in San Diego County. And then we do that by sequencing the virus in everybody. Everybody has a unique strain, basically, and we can figure out the relatedness of these strains to come up with clusters. And sometimes these clusters grow and expand very quickly. And once we're able to identify that in real time, then we can do prevention efforts specifically related to those clusters.
And how will the results of your study be used?
Hopefully, it'll be a good prevention way to keep actively evolving transmission networks from spreading. So we could actually stop it at the very beginning before it spreads to multiple people and gets out of control.
Dr. Morris, you participated in a study a couple of years back showing that the blood test was, I think, a little bit better in early detection of HIV than other methods, but that was not frequently used. How frequently used is it now?
Well, things have developed from that, and we still do that test, and Dr. Smith is part of this, in nucleic acid testing for people that have had recent infection, people are out that are before they develop the antibodies. There are some newer tests that also test for viral antigen that are very effective. There's a lot of things underway to try to use these methods to detect these small segment of people that are very infectious and are very earlier in their infection, because those are the people we want to get on therapy now. That's the whole idea of prevention, get people diagnosed and treated.
And what about an AIDS vaccine? How far away are we from this?
Well, impression is that we're quite a ways away from it. I mean, I think there's a strong impetus to fund research into vaccines, and we'd all love to have a vaccine. It would just be so much easier to control HIV throughout the world. However, it's a very difficult virus to target, and so far we have not had a lot of success.
Very quickly, Dr. Smith, what's the biggest challenge that is faced, that everyone is faced with in fighting AIDS?
There are two big things that we need to do on the research side. One is a cure and the other is a vaccine, and we go to work every day to try to come up with efforts on those. In the meantime, we need better prevention efforts, and that's what we're here to discuss today, both in terms of pre-exposure prophylaxis with what Dr. Morris is doing, and also these epidemiology processes.
Dr. Smith, Dr. Morris, thank you so much for coming on the show.